It is 9 a.m. Monday, September 14th, 2020. Wilson County Commissioners Court is now in session. We'll have the opening prayer by Rick Rutland, Chaplain of the Sonic Lodge, Stockdale Sonic Lodge, 4147.
Would you pray with me, please? Our dear Heavenly Father, we thank you for this beautiful, glorious day you've given us. We also thank you for all of our many, many blessings, especially this of this wonderful country that we live in. Help us to always look to you for guidance and comfort. Please be with all those who are suffering right now from natural disasters or fires or hurricanes or whatever. Please be with all those who need your assistance right now. Please be with our leaders and give them wisdom and compassion and help them to look to you for guidance. Please watch over us and protect us always, and in the end, take us to you in heaven. In Christ's name we pray. Amen.
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 To the United States of America, and to the Republic for which it stands, one nation, under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all. Texas flag. I pledge allegiance to thee, Texas, one state, under God, one and indivisible.
Thank you, Rick. And we now have Commissioner Wiley. I have lots of trouble with traffic in Stockdale myself.
Yeah, I have to turn around and go back to before 17.
Okay, moving right along to agenda item number 3, public comments. Thanks. So, Mr. Wade, here's two of these are for the tax hearing, and we have one that's public health, and that's the one I'm going to call right now. It's Atlanta Brown.
On behalf of citizens, Sorry. Not asking for this help. I'm asking how we're ended. This goes on and on and on. We're going to have to make a choice if we choose not to serve this, not this our community. So for those of you that ran as Republicans on the Republican ticket, to remember that as we see in the Republican Party platform, we believe in the Constitution as our founding document. We believe the Constitution was written not as a flexible document, but as our enduring covenant. We believe our constitutional system, limited government, separation of powers, federalism, and the rights of the people must be preserved uncompromised for future generations. So on behalf of citizens of Wilson County and voters, we once again ask that Judge Jackson submit the face covering exemption form. That's all. Thank you.
Thank you. And Ms. Berlanga. Okay. That wasn't on the agenda, so there's no comment made, but there is one thing that I want to bring to everybody's attention. We have 22 active cases in Wilson County, and the face covering mandate comes from the governor, not the county judge. Thank you.
Good job, Judge.
Okay, we have more comments, but one of them is Mr. Phillips is going to be on agenda item 20, and another two are when our tax hearing is, so we're going to come back to those. Certificates of completion and awards.
I don't have any at this time, Judge.
Don, do you have that?
No, I gave it to her retirement party.
Okay. So we did have a retirement of 23 years. Almost 23 years from the tax office, retired this last
August 31st.
August 31st, yes. Okay, so we have none. Extension activity reports, the handouts. Agenda item number six, we're going to come back to at 10 a.m. It is Richfield Jackson County Judge, Bender Trevino County Auditor. A 2020 tax rate hearing. Okay, so we'll come back to that. So we're going to agenda item number seven, Richard L. Jackson County Judge, discuss and take action on IT Professionals Day proclamation. Proclamation, County of Wilson, Texas, designation of September 15th, 2020 as National IT Professionals Day. Whereas the power of technology is wielding a huge impact on the world today, and whereas the U.S. tech industry is a major driving force in the overall economy, accounting for 7.1% of overall GDP and 11.6% of U.S. private sector employment. Whereas information technology draws on highly educated and skilled U.S. workforce of nearly 2 million people in a number which has continued to grow during the past decade, and whereas cloud computing, mobility, big data, automation, and social technologies become common elements for business of all sizes, and as cybersecurity becomes a constant concern, the need for employees for technical experience is growing, and whereas booming technology, economic, and demographic shifts continue to rapidly change in our world, it is more important than ever for organizations, for small businesses, to government agencies to embrace effective information technology practices. Therefore, I, Richard L. Jackson, County Judge of Wilson County, Texas, do hereby proclaim September 15th as 2020 as National IT Professional Day in Wilson County, and that should have been Commissioner's Court of Wilson County. We'll get that one changed. Make a motion by Commissioner Bob.
Also.
Second by Commissioner Roddy. Proclaim September 15th, IT Professional Day. Is there any discussion? All in favor?
Aye.
Any opposed?
You still have to work, John. You can take off.
Does that mean John's going to bake the cake?
I don't know. Well, thank y'all. It's quite an honor, really unexpected, and I've got Layton and Lisa here. They work with me in the Wilson County IT department. Just on behalf of all IT professionals in Wilson County, thank y'all.
Thank you. Thank you. And we'll get that change to Wilson County Commissioner's Court for all of us to sign it. Okay. Moving on to agenda item number 8, Richard L. Jackson County Judge Joe D. Taxi County Sheriff. Discuss and take action on setting sheriff and constable fees for 2020. Is there any change?
No, sir.
Everything's going to stay the same? If we're not changing, do we have to?
Yes, we submit a no change.
Okay.
Yes, we'll go ahead and take care of that.
But we don't have to take any action?
Right.
Okay, good deal. So we're moving right along. Okay, agenda item number 9, Richard L. Jackson County Judge. Discuss and take action on allowing the County Memorial Medical Center to use the Wilson County Expo and Community Center for an adult flu clinic for the public on September 23rd, 2020. From 4 p.m. to 6:30 p.m., fees will be waived. Okay, they're having a clinic that is the want to, and it's of no cost. Any adult that shows up from 4 o'clock to 6:30 will get a free flu vaccination. And depending on the number of, if they have enough vaccine, which they do, the way they talk, they would have more than enough to go through for the 2 hours of vaccinations. They're having and I don't have the date on here, but they're having a free clinic out at their clinic out north of town for children. But I do not have the date on that.
Are the fees that will be waived our fees?
Yes.
We won't charge them?
Yes. If they're not charging the public,
we're not
going to use our facility.
Well, I'll make a motion we allow Sam to use the show law for the clinic.
Motion by Commissioner Hyde, second by Commissioner Gomez. We allow County Memorial Medical Center to use the Wilson County Expo and Community Center. Is there any discussion? All in favor?
Aye.
Aye. Any opposed? Okay, that motion. Okay, agenda item number 10, Richard L. Jackson County Judge. Discuss and take action on resolution authorizing grant Texas Department of Agriculture, Texas Feeding Texans Home Delivered Meals Grant Program. Okay. And this is Department of Agriculture, Texas Feeding Texans Home Delivered Meals Grant Program Resolution Authorizing County Grant Program Year 2021. A resolution of the County of Wilson, Texas, certifying that the county has made a grant to the Plumhall County Senior Citizen Foundation, an organization that provides home delivered meals to homebound persons in the county who are elderly and or have a disability, and certifying that the county has approved the organization's accounting system for fiscal year. Whereas the organization desires to apply for grant funding from the Texas Department of Agriculture to supplement and extend existing services for homebound persons in the county who are elderly and or have a disability. pursuant to the Home Delivered Meals Grant Program. And whereas the program rules require the county in which the organization is providing home delivered meals to make a grant to the organization in order for the organization to be eligible to receive program grant funds. And whereas the program rules require the county to approve the organization's accounting system or fiscal agent in order for the organization to be eligible to receive program grant funds. And whereas the county recognizes Ken Lowry as an official of the organization applying for home delivered meal grant for the Texas Department of Agriculture. Be it resolved by the county, section one, the county hereby certifies it has made a grant to the organization in the amount of $2,059 to be used between the 1st of September 2020 and the 31st of August 2021. Section two, the county hereby certifies that the organization provides home delivered meals to homebound persons in the county who are elderly and or have a disability. Section three, the county hereby certifies it has approved the organization's accounting system or fiscal agent, which meets financial management system requirements as set forth in the Uniform Grant Management Standards promulgated by the Texas Comptroller of Public Accounts. Introduced, read, and passed by the affirmative vote of the county on the 14th day of September 2020. Okay, we have this money budgeted already, but whatever year it used to go to do. County senior citizens, but now they no longer do it, and Comal County Senior Citizens Foundation has taken over.
So we're making the grant to the Texas Department of Agriculture?
No, we're making it to Comal County Seniors, Comal County Senior Citizens Foundation.
Yeah, basically Meals on Wheels, they provide.
That's it. But they don't provide, they don't do the Meals on Wheels, they do the... Yes.
I'll make a motion to do it.
Motion by Commissioner Fowle.
I'll second.
Second by Commissioner Hyatt. Is there any discussion? All in favor?
Aye.
Any opposed? Agenda item 11, Lynchville, Jackson County Judge Don Barnett, Wilson County Tax Assessor Collector, discuss and take action on the Texas Parks and Wildlife Department County Boat Agent Agreement.
Good morning. This is just a renewal for my office to continue processing Texas Parks and Wildlife transactions, boat and vessel renewals, title transfers and so forth. It's nothing new. It's the same contract that we had before. I'm just asking y'all to review it so we can continue to provide this service to the citizens of the county.
I make a motion to do it, Judge.
A motion by Commissioner Wiley, second by Commissioner Hyatt. We renew the agreement. Is there any more discussion? All in favor?
Aye.
Aye. Any opposed? Motion carries. Is there something to sign?
It is, yeah. I'll get it to you and Ms. Eva.
Okay. Okay, agenda item 12, Richard L. Jackson County Judge John Holcomb, IT Director, discuss and potential action to enroll all current and future Wilson County personnel who have access to a government computer system or database into the TAC cybersecurity training course pursuant to the Texas Government Code 2054.519.
Thank you. We have a yearly requirement now that any county employees or any government employees with access to a government computer system or database take an annual cybersecurity training course. So I'm just asking for permission to go ahead and enroll all the county employees with access to a computer system or database into this training course. And also I'm asking for permission to continue doing this throughout the year, or even if it's possible beyond the year, as long as this requirement is in place.
Is
Is this essentially the same thing we did earlier this year, late last year?
Yes, sir.
Just a repeat of it?
This is it.
It just took him a whole year to get all of this to do.
We get to do it every year.
Let's do it.
I move to place the...
Okay, motion by Commissioner Fowle, second by Commissioner Gomez. We get John to hotshot everybody into getting their training for their course.
John, how soon will it open?
I'll try and we'll get together, get a list of employees together, and then I'll get with Jalen probably later today, and we'll work on getting a list together and submit it to them of all the employees.
Is it calendar year or fiscal year? When does it begin and when does it end?
You know, I don't, be honest with you, I don't remember the start and end dates. I just know the window is open now. I don't have that with me. I apologize.
So even the ones of us that took it last year, we're ready to do it again?
Like yes,
we
sir.
We just took it in June, we do it again. I think the deadline was July.
Right. Right, and then I think that's when the year starts again. I don't think it aligns with the calendar year or the fiscal year. I think it's got its own.
And you're thinking what day?
I'm thinking that it's August to July.
I'm gonna keep checking until I get it right.
Okay, we've got a motion and a second. Is there any more discussion? All in favor?
Aye.
Aye. Any opposed? Okay. Everybody give permission to us and join the computer. Okay, agenda item 13, discuss and take action on letting voter registration registrar. This should be county judge. Linda Lambert to use the courthouse lawn and parking lot September 19th from 10 a.m. to 2 p.m. for voter registration. That's just she wants to set up down here and people come through and just give them form to register to vote. Motion by Commissioner Gomez.
No, second.
Second by Commissioner Wiley. We allow that to happen. Is there any more discussion? All in favor?
Aye.
Aye. Any opposed? So that passes. Okay. Agenda item 14. Richard L. Jackson, County Judge. Brenda L. Trevino, County Auditor. Discuss and take action on awarding funds for the Wilson County CARES Grant Program.
Yes.
This is it.
So on August 31st, or back in August, you guys had it approved for us to establish a county grant program to assist some businesses that might be eligible based on criteria. We formed that committee and have been working diligently since then. The applications opened August 31st, and I'm sorry, August 31st, I'm sorry, August, July 31st, and we're due August the 14th, I believe it was, August, yes. And then what we did is we created, Michelle and I, from the our grant manager created a scoring rubric, and we, and there were all these different criteria, and based on their scores, those are the awards. We had a total of 43 applicants. Out of the 43, 28 are eligible in the different ranges, and that's what we presented before you. So we are asking the court's approval to proceed with paying out those awards.
Okay, so this is the 25% of the CARES Act money that
it
you
is.
Got. This
is
just take care of the whole 25%?
I don't know if it's wraps
up. Did you say that at what time did you say
this? The CRF CARES grant, CARES money.
Okay.
Yes, unless we spend more money for the other categories in that CRF funds, this will complete out the 25% that's eligible for economic support.
And the total payout equated to $101,000.
There's,
it's not a loan, it's a grant.
It's a grant, that's correct.
Commissioner Gomez and I sat on sit with. I don't know exactly how the term would be.
As advisory on the committee.
On the committee. And from my perspective, did a really good job of making certain that this thing was done professionally and without failure. So I just want to commend you on that.
Thank you.
The parameters I thought were good.
Did a well job.
Yeah, we had businesses from every corner of the county, which we were pleased to see, which included Lavernia, Poe, Stockdale, Floresville, so.
I make a motion, we approve it.
I'll make a second.
Motion by Commissioner Wiley, second by Commissioner Gomez, that we approve the business. The grant recipients?
Yeah, have a nice little board.
Okay. Okay, is there any more discussion? All in favor?
Judge, what was the kind of the criteria that some of these, I saw, you know, some get more money than others. If you don't mind, just.
Yep, so the scoring rubric included seven different areas, which included the completion of the application, everything that was required to be submitted. Their evidence of legitimately having business in the state. Evidence of not exceeding gross revenues of $1 million. Evidence of loss. Evidence of need, they had to write a narrative, and evidence of any other donation, any other assistance received, not that that disqualified them at all. It was just how, basically, how honest were people being. And so each one of those criteria were weighted. And so depending on, and one of the things that Michelle and I did is we scored individually first, and we were very close when we came together to review our results at how very close that we were collectively. And so everybody ranged within 1 to 2 points from our individual score. So we knew we were on the right track.
Okay.
You're welcome.
Any other questions? Okay, all in favor?
Aye.
Aye. Any opposed? So we have approved our list of grant recipients. Do y'all want to take a picture?
Yeah, why don't take stand over there.
Michelle, get over here. Come down.
Out, and I talked to a couple of commissioners on what priority roadways. They saw wanted to get funded. So we removed some roads. We removed three roads per the commissioners in those precincts. And as you see at the bottom, it all equals out to the award that we received from the state, which was $430,205. So we're using the total award from the state, and we're going to match that with county funds of $107,551. And that totals to $537,756. This, these roadways can be completed within 5 years, so it's not something that could impact greatly next year's budget or fall through, but we can kind of spread it out over the 5 years.
Mr. Chairman, you said 537?
537,756 is the total project amount.
I have a question. I'm having a problem with any of this. My question has to do with the funding.
Mm-hmm.
If you take, of course, we'll look at Precinct 2. It looks like he has $263,000 for these two projects. I'm looking at this. And I've got 200 and something or another. Do we know with this project, once we turn in, once we complete a project and we have the paperwork and we turn it in to you, what their timetable for reimbursement is going to be?
I do not know that. I'm assuming what I would like to do and what I know I've heard from Leanne is the faster you turn in your, the more regular you turn in your paperwork. So like on a monthly basis, which is what I would like to do. They're going to be prepared to handle that and give us back our money.
My question has to do with this. If you take my budget, take Commissioner Miles' budget, and I'm sure Commissioner Gaines as well, and you pull that much out of the budget in the course of a year to do that, then that may impede your ability to do other things within the county. Can we set this up so that this is handled, we turn it in, handle through the general fund or something, the general fund is reimbursed?
In the course of the budget, I have included county matching grant funds as a line item for purposes like this. So it would not affect your current budget in your prospective road and bridge funds.
Excellent.
Okay, matching funds are not going to be any kind of contributions?
I'm sure some of them.
I mean, we're going to use the county forces that we've identified on there. It will be equipment, the rate for equipment, the rate for the workers to use. So, yes.
It should go, quite frankly, you think, because they're allowing us to, you have to count for everything, but, you know, motor graders a certain rate per hour, water trucks a different rate, dump trucks, pickup. So when you take that and labor, that, quite frankly, it should cover all of that, in my opinion. But at least in the past situations we have, it has covered.
But I think what you're talking about more, Commissioner Mahaly, is that like the 430 that the TxDOT is going to give us, they won't give us that money until we turn in our...
Oh, no, that's right. The question had to do with
the actual budget.
The part that...
Yes. What he's saying, taking it out, instead of taking it out of our budget.
Yeah.
That's a big chunk of change.
Okay. Yeah. But obviously, when you're talking about... But if you're the folks that are going to do it, we're already paying, and we already own the equipment. So as far as having to come up with money to offset that, or you could hire a contractor, I guess. But as opposed to, you know, coming up with money, that money should be covered.
Yes.
by the work that we do, it has an impact.
I don't think there was a stipulation on this. I'll go back and check. Nothing was required.
And it hasn't happened yet, but say we submit something to them, costs, are they going to say, okay, 20% of that, whatever it is going to be y'all's, and we'll pay for the other, reimburse you for the other part of it?
But you're going to have to prove, and that's going to be key from the standpoint of the form that we use.
Yeah.
You're going to have to prove, you're going to have to track how many hours that, you know, John Doe worked X number of hours on the maintainer, and that maintainer better be used the same amount of hours. If the other person drove a dump truck, then dump trucks have to account for that, so it all has to tie back together, but it's not that complicated.
And I'm sure they have forms on that will be accounted for who is.
Or less, my question is, if we submit them.
$100,000.
$100,000, they just going to give us $80,000?
I'll confirm with that, but that's, usually agencies have the form already split out, so they show you what they will be in order and what our cost is. So I know TCQ has shown it here as well, so I'm confident that that's about the price.
Okay.
So I'll work with that.
Okay.
Now, if we don't use this dollar amount, they don't cost that much, we have estimated the road, then we can use it on another road?
Technically, yes, and that's why.
But that's what we did in the past.
Right.
But it would need to be another road that we submit.
Yes.
Right.
Not just a random.
Yes. But as you can see on this road, and I'm going to contact, TxDOT to learn if they are going to be rigid on the actual description of the carbon description. Because a lot of the roads that y'all have removed, y'all can simply apply those funds to the other roads that aren't getting completed. My conversations with TxDOT has already said, they've already said that they're going to be flexible and work with us. So I don't think we will have too much of a problem.
Now, at least on the last project, the only key, obviously you have to keep up with the invoices, and you'll have to turn the invoices in for all of the materials that you use. The other part is keeping really good records as to who did what, where. You don't really, the wind's not so much. It's going to be, you have a 8-hour day or a 10-hour day, depending on which precinct you're in, and it's accounting for the use of your people and equipment in the course of that 10-hour day. And it covers everything from trailers to getting equipment out there. It's the whole bit.
And if they don't have a form, then I will work with them as well as you will make sure to develop
a good response to the council. To make it easy. We'll make a motion.
Motion by Commissioner Gomez, second by Commissioner Hyatt, that we approve the TIF grant agreement. Is there any more discussion? All in favor?
Aye.
Any opposed? Okay. So now we're going to 15B, discuss and take action to approve the Alamo Area Council of Government with the Texas Commission on Environmental Quality grant agreement for the expansion of Wilson County Citizens Collection.
Commissioners, this grant, as you all have been made aware of and have been updated several times, we started in December. This is the actual approval of the agreement. By the way, the county attorney's office has looked at it. Their only concern was following the civil work here for the grant. Commissioner Powell about it. Using the contractor, using the subject for the engineering, we were awarded the grant. $56,915 will come from TCQ / ACOG. ACOG is the administrator of this grant on their side, and then we will match that with another $56,915. Half of that $56,915 has to be a cash match. And it's $28,457 cash, which is already been budgeted for the new year, and $28,457 that's in impact services. Those impact services can include, obviously, the work done by the county.
Cheryl, I'm sorry, could you turn around and repeat the number?
The number is $56,915 of grant money from TCEQ, administered by ACOG, and with a match of $56,915 from the county.
Okay.
Half of that $56,915 from the county has to be cash, and half of it has to be impact.
Okay, thank you so much.
So we just simply track equipment and so forth like we did. We'll probably use the same text dot numbers, I hope.
Yeah.
What we will need is the labor breakdown to where it's a burden of everything. Insurance. So if someone gets $12 an hour, by the time you load in insurance and other benefits, then that 12 might be 16 or 18. So we need those numbers for everybody that participates in both of these units.
Right, exactly. I've had some of that work up, I think you requested from the treasurer's office when we were initially preparing the grant, and so we'll just get those updated.
Motion by Commissioner Fowler.
I'll second.
Second by Commissioner Wiley. We approve the ACOG TCEQ grant for the collection facility. Is there any more discussion?
No, if just a statement, Judge, is that to me, this is a really big deal. That this is going to take the collection facility to a new level. We should be able, I would think, to have all of our events that we have out there. It's going to familiarize a number of citizens with the collection facility, which will make a really big difference, I think, for our roads and so forth in the long term. I'm excited.
And the credit we have to give is to Michelle, because she was working on this before she was our transit manager. So, okay, motion and a second. Any more discussion? Good. All in favor?
Aye.
Aye. Aye. Any opposed? So, thank you.
Thank you.
Okay, now 15C, discuss and take action to approve a resolution of support to renew the statewide automated victims notification service, SAVIS grant, administered by the Texas Office of the Attorney General through the state's vendor of press.
All right, one last one. This is a contract that we've had, I believe, a couple years, or just a year. So it just got transitioned to my department. They're requiring a resolution and to renew the contract. I did have the county attorney's office look at it. There's only one concern, the dates that they're putting into the actual resolution, and I verified it on the actual contract grant agreement. The dates are exactly what they say in the resolution, so I'll contact that person to on that, but let me read the resolution. First contract renewal participating in these services agreement for the statewide automated victim notification service. Contract number 2020-2144-900-527-01. Whereas the Office of the Attorney General is a Texas state agency tasked with certifying a statewide vendor to provide a statewide automated victim notification service to a variety of political subdivisions of the state of Texas, including counties, county sheriffs, clerks, and attorneys, district attorneys, and courts participating. Whereas Wayne being certified and contracted with Appers, Inc., the vendor, as a statewide vendor to provide SAVIS to each of the participating entities. Whereas Wilson County, Texas, as a participating entity and vendor, executed a participating services agreement identified as contract number 2019-2024-900-527-01, under which vendors would provide SAVIS to Wilson County, mainly. where a section one of the contract permitted the main entity to, and it's sole and absolute discretion to renew the contract for four additional one-year renewal terms. Each renewal term to be extended to the OAB certification agreement remains in effect. Whereas the OAB exercises its option to renew the OAB certification agreement extending the term thereof to August 31st, 2022. Now therefore, the first contract renewal is exercised by Wilson County as follows. The contract is set to terminate on August 31st, 2020. The contract is hereby renewed with this first contract renewal term to begin on September 1, 2020 and end August 31st, 2021. Pursuant to section one of the contract's first renewal term and any subsequent renewal shall be subject to all specifications and terms and conditions of the contract. OAB certification agreement and incorporated documents as defined in section 2 of the rules.
Okay, we're going to agenda item 16. Okay, Richard L. Jackson County Judge Tom Caldwell, County Attorney, approve and adopt Wilson County Emergency Service District Number 5, Resolution 2020-004, and Resolution 2020-005. Jackson, you know anything about that? Nothing. So. Take no action on that. If he needs time, we can put it back on the agenda for next time.
Does he have to be here? Or?
What's that?
Caldwell here? Or?
I don't know.
So I think that's just their resolution to adopt the tax rate. I don't know that y'all need to.
And that's what I was wondering. Tom wanted to put it on the agenda, so I did.
Yes, he wanted it on YouTube.
What's that?
He wanted it on YouTube.
Yeah, he wanted it on the agenda.
Maybe since it's their first time to adopt.
Do y'all have a document? Other than it being in here?
We'll need to look.
We have an authority over their tax rate.
That's our stuff.
Where?
The district's in its office. Or is it here?
It's right here, Judge. It's got all the information on there.
He sent that in the email.
We've already read the agenda item, and this is something that to present to Commissioner's Court to for ESD 5 to adopt their.
Sorry,
oh, okay.
The resolutions.
Okay, gentlemen, to be clear on this, this is not something you actually vote on, but by law, ESDs, I can't speak to the ones that don't represent, but I do know the ones that do. By law, they have to give Commissioner's Court and the counties that they're in, they have to give them a copy of the adopted budget. That's all that was. I gave it to Ms. Martinez, and that's it. Only because she is the, you know, kind of the custodian of records for Commissioner's Court. But it was just me serving them to y'all. Both ESDs have adopted a budget and a tax rate. They come on board.
We have no authority over them.
No, no, you don't. But they have, emergency service districts have a requirement to keep the county in the loop about certain things. I think about three things a year, one of which is they have to provide y'all with their proposed, their adopted tax rates, their adopted budgets, and they also have a report due to y'all in the school. That's all that was. I'm sorry if those are...
So this is just...
Do we have to take action to receive it?
No, no. The law says that you are to be served with a copy.
Okay, so we don't approve it?
No, those are the law. I believe the law, I'm paraphrasing, is the ESD shall serve the Commissioner's Court with a copy.
Okay.
That's exactly what I did.
Okay.
So we can serve?
Yes. I'm not suing.
And I guarantee you, in 3 years, somebody's gonna ask, did we ever serve them? And we're gonna be fine in the minutes.
Yeah, we will.
Okay.
Is this your document, sir?
It's mine.
Okay.
It's mine.
Judge, I'll state, the 8 years I've been involved with our ESD, the only reporting we've done is two items. We send our finalized audit to the county auditor, and we provide the tax rate information to the tax assessor clerk. And that's the two things that we've been doing for, since our...
Okay. Thank you. Okay, well, we've got that. So that's it, yes, sir. Okay, we're moving right along. Agenda item 17. Judge Jackson County Judge, discuss and take action on approving interlocal agreement with ESD 4 and 5 to collect ad valorem taxes.
Here are the original interlocals. It's the same agreement that I have with all of the other taxing entities, where I will collect and disperse the tax money. It also states that I will calculate tax rates for them, but it's no different than any of the other ones that we already have in place.
Okay. To approve both of them? Okay. 4 and 5. Motion by Commissioner Fowle. Second by Commissioner Gombrich that we approve both interlocal agreements. Is there any more discussion? All in favor?
Aye.
Aye. Any opposed? Okay. Motion carries. Skip agenda item number 18 because it has to be done after agenda item number 6, and we haven't done agenda item number 6 yet. So that is our tax rate here. So we're going to agenda item number 19, Richard L. Jackson County Judge, Arthur Marrero, Elections Administrator, and Voter Registrar. Request to amend voting locations for Box 102 from Floresville ISD School Annex to Sacred Heart Catholic Church.
Yes, good morning, Judge, Commissioner. I'm requesting your approval to be able to change it to the Catholic Parish Hall, Sacred Heart Catholic Parish Hall, due to the fact that I will be having 3 elections, and the Floresville Annex, the ISG is not big enough.
Okay, and everything else is the same?
Everything is okay, this is that new location, Box 102.
Motion by Commissioner Gomez, second by Commissioner Fowle, that we accept accept the amended polling locations. Is there any more discussion? All in favor?
Aye.
Any opposed? Motion carries. Let's wait 4 more minutes, and we're going to go back to agenda